Hi everybody, my name is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbellRocks.com. Today I'm going to show you how to use Google Translate and Google Meet to get a live closed caption in a bunch of different languages, working with students and families who speak languages other than English. So let's get started. First we're going to go to meet.google.com. We will join a meeting. We'll click on Test Meet, that's what I named mine. Going to turn off my camera. Going to join the meeting now. When we turn on closed caption, that's the first thing that we're going to do. We have two options. We can turn it on right down here where it says closed captions at the bottom. We also can click on the ice cream cone and turn off captions here. Once we have our captions here, we left click or control click on a Mac. And you'll see right here where it says Translate to English. We're gonna click right there. And now what we'll have up here is we have this little Google Translate navigation bar that jumps up here in the end of our navigation bar, excuse me. When we choose another language, we'll see this drop down. We have all of these different tools here, these different languages that we can translate into. So if we click on Spanish, and hit translate, what will happen is it will pull all of the text as I'm talking live in the closed caption will be Spanish. If I change that to, let's say, French, and I hit translate, it's going to automatically translate everything that I've already spoken, but will also give me a live translation. Now, is this a perfect translation? Absolutely not, but it's definitely better than no translation at all. Again, to recap, once we have our closed caption, we left click here. We already have the translate here. It's in French. You'll see right up here this Google Translate, this page. Click on the ice cream cone again. We can choose another language. We're going to now go to Dutch, click on Translate. That's how you can live translate your Google Meet into tons of different languages. You can teach this to your students. You can teach this to the parents. You can actually share this tutorial with them to show this how to do this on their Chromebook at home. I have a special message for you right now. Thank you for watching this video all the way till the end. And thank you for what you do for kids on a daily basis. If this video saved you time, energy, and frustration, go ahead and like, subscribe, and share it with your teacher friends. You can subscribe by clicking up here, or you can watch another video either here or here. Again, I love you, I appreciate you, and I'm glad that you're here.